In this illustration, we'll analyze a cylinder in equilibrium on inclined plane. If we are given that a cylinder of mass m and radius r is kept on an inclined plane and it is supported by a vertical string wrapped on it as shown in the figure. Here, to keep the cylinder in equilibrium in this state, we are required to find the minimum required coefficient of friction between cylinder and inclined plane and the tension in the string. Now, in this situation, here we redraw the figure to analyze it properly. This angle is alpha and here we have kept a cylinder. And a force is acting on the cylinder in upward direction. Here the weight of cylinder mg is in downward direction, which will have two components. Along the incline and perpendicular to incline, which are mg cos alpha and mg sin alpha. And a normal reaction would be acting on the cylinder from the inclined plane. And due to the torque applied by the string, cylinder has a clockwise rotation tendency, which is opposed by the friction, which is in limiting case of value mu n, and that will be opposing it. Now, in this situation here, we can write for equilibrium of cylinder, we use, in this situation here, we can write in horizontal direction, if you just have a look, horizontally, the component of friction is mu n cos alpha, and to the left side, the component of n will be, if this angle is alpha, here we can write it n sin alpha. So, in this situation, for equilibrium of cylinder, we can write n sin alpha is equals to mu n cos alpha, which gives us the value of mu, that is 10 alpha. So, that is one result of the problem, the minimum coefficient of friction required to keep the cylinder at rest. And we can say it is in equilibrium, we can balance the forces in any direction. So, if we write in direction normal to incline, here we use, we can see in the direction normal to incline, this force is having a component f cos alpha, and we can write other components here are, this f cos alpha plus n should be equals to mg cos alpha. And for rotational equilibrium of a cylinder, here we use, you can write fr must be equals to mu n r, because the two torques must balance each other. So, this gives us the value of external force or the tension, the string should be equals to mu n. So, this equation 1 we can write, from equation 1 if we substitute the value of f as mu n over here, here you can see we will get the value in this situation n multiplied by mu cos alpha, that will be sin alpha. So, this is sin alpha plus 1 is equals to mg cos alpha. So, this has given us the value of n, normal reaction acting on the cylinder, which is mg cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha. So, if this is the value of n, if we substitute n over here, we can get the value of tension in a string as here the value of tension we are getting f is mu n. So, this is mu mg cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha, that is the result of this problem.